Hi student, I am Ashit Tiwari, assistant teacher. The lesson which is continue, the lifeline of the national economy, the topics which is going on, it is the types of road. So students, we will study the different type of the roads day by day. Yesterday we study about the golden quadrilateral superhighway. Today we will study the other roads, the remaining roads, type of road, one by one. So student, today's roads, it has the national highways. National highways are the type of roads types of road that connect the all important routes. Second things, there are nearly 228 national highways. These highways contain 2.7% part in all roads. These roads are maintained by CPWD. This is the department which take care the types of road. The longest national highway is NH 44. This road, this road earlier known as NH 7. So many of the other roads contain in this type of the road, such as any other highways are merged in it, such as NH 1A, NH 110, NH 2, NH 3, NH 75, NH 2, NH 7, and these are the types of road which are connected by it. The roads which length is, the length of this road is 3745 kilometer. This is the longest road. The student hope all of you could understand well. So student, we will study the objectives. Number one, these roads provide the essential goods and services. Second, these roads that these roads connect the state for trades and commercial activities. Number third, these roads plays a significant role in development. That is very important things. So students, the other roads we will study one by one. State highways are very important in India, because these state highways, are maintained by SPWD. It is a state level department. Is here the roads. These state highways connect the state headquarter to all district headquarter. That is very important things. These state highways are very important and their length is near about 400,000 kilometers. Some states have maximum share in state highways. These states are Maharashtra, Karnataka, Gujarat, Rajasthan, एंड तमिल नाडु. स्टेट हैव ए लार्जेस्ट शेयर इन द रूट्स. दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग्स. सो स्टूडेंट, होप यू कुड अंडरस्टैंड वेल द स्टेट हाईवे. District road connect the district headquarter to all roads of district level. That is very important. Yes. Second, these roads are maintained by, that is very important things, Jila Parishad. So you should keep all these things in the mind. The total length of these roads in India is 600,000 kilometers. These roads play a very important role for development of the district. That is very important things. So students, these are the village roads. These roads connect the village with neighboring town and cities. That is very important things, that neighboring towns and cities, they get the development by the village roads. Second, these roads play a very vital role in the development of the village. That is very important thing, because a village needs a lot of needs, such as the banks, the electricity, and many of the other necessities. These roads help the farmers to take their products to cities and district headquarters. That is very important things, because if the farmers is connected by the well connected road, then they can sell their product in the market or near by the mandi, and they can get the huge profit. These roads received importance under the Pradhan Mantri Gramin Sadak Yojana. This was a program which was launched by the UPA government, and in this program many of the profit has been given to the village level. So student, you could understand well all these points. So student, border roads, which are very important. Border roads organization was established in 1960. That is very important thing, and it is a 1 marks question also. For the development of the roads of the strategic importance in the northern and the northeastern border, you know very well, in India the problem occurs at the northeastern border, especially in this area. Especially the northern and the northern state area, where we have a lot of challenges. So these roads which are developed, which help us to, we'll say, stand against the enemy's countries, and that is a very important thing. You have seen also the Doklams, you will say, the conflict with China, and at present time the China which also produced the kind of conflict in this area. That is very important thing. So these two areas which are the example of the good roads, if we have the good road network, so we have gave the very stiff challenge to the our enemies countries, our neighboring countries, and they face a lot of difficulties. That is very important things. So these are very important for the strategic importance. Means we have a also lot of stamina to fight against our enemies with only by the help of these border roads. Second, these roads have improved accessibility in areas of deficient terrain, because in this area mostly the area is made by the physiographic division. If you study, so you will find there the mountain, the hill, the valleys, and in this area if the roads are developed, it means they are not only helping the armies, our defense, but also these roads are very important for the development of the local areas, because the people who are living there, they have a lot of scarcities of many of the goods, many of the other essential goods, and they have to face all these difficulties in their day-to-day life. So that is very important that the border roads development has been done after the organization which was made in the year 1960, and that is very important things. So student, hope you could understand well all these points one by one. So student, we will study here the topic that is very important and it should be discussed. Roadways have an age over railways due to the following reason. It is very important. This is a 3 marks question and it appears in the exam mostly. Number one, roads require less investment as compared to railways, because railway need the terrain, means plain terrain, flat terrain, then it will clear the land, then it will lay down the roads, then it will lay down the railway track, then it will lead down the different type of other material to support the railway tracks. So it is very, you say, cheaper than comparison to the railway. Second important things, these roads can be built at higher altitude. Higher altitude means in this area there is a mountain, so roads can be built in this area very easily. But if it is compared with the railway, so there is a lot of cost. It will be very costly if the railways can be built at the higher altitude. Higher altitude means बहुत ज़्यादा ऊंचाई पे यदि रेलवे बनाई जाती है तो उसमें बहुत ज़्यादा दिक्कतें आ जाती हैं. बिकॉज द माउंटेन स्टोन्स हैव टू बी ब्लास्ट बाई द डायनामाइट, दैन द रोड्स कैन बी बिल्ट आफ्टर पेविंग द रोड्स, दैन ओवर द रोड्स द रेलवे ट्रैक हैज़ बीन मेड. नेक्स्ट वन इज द मेंटेनेंस कॉस्ट इज वेरी लो, दैट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग्स. इफ इट इज़ कंपेयर विद द रेलवेज, so the maintenance cost of the roadways is very low, because railways track, if they are injured, if they are, you say, sabotaged, so many of the challenges the railway department have to face. If the roadways is going to be, you say, destroyed, it maintenance cost of the roadways is very lower if it is compared with the railways. Then roads transportation has the merit of offering personal services, that is very important things. Personal services where a person can go to the their destination with their own vehicle from their own house, means roadways provide them the door to door service, that is very important things. Next one, extension of the agriculture is possible only through the road transport, because it has been also observed in India and many of the other countries where the good roads network was there, then agriculture developed in that countries, in that areas. Even we have seen it also in the villages which are developed due to the good network of the roadway. It is easy and is within the reach of common man, that is very important things. Means if you go or if you want to use the roadways, then you have to purchase very, we'll say, cheaper vehicles and they can run over the roadways. Because if you use the other modes of the transportation, so it means you have to pay the very higher cost to use the other modes of the transport, to use in the water, to use in the air. Then roads transport is used as a feeder, that is very important point, to other modes of the transport, means it is connected to railways, it connect to the waterways, means the shipyard, the aerodrome in airport, which can easily connect by the roadways. If the railways has been laid down, so there will be a very heavy cost. So hope all the students could understand well this topic, and you should enjoy all this topic. And in the first, you should read the topic in the book, then you should listen the videos. It will understand you better in compare without reading from the book. So hope all the students could understand well. Thank you.